I love all of the sentiment, and I think that where as I'm looking in the chat also from Heather, I think this is one thing. I mean, it's great to also have a model and a vision of how you want to live your life. There's also the practical challenges of making that a reality, particularly if you have multiple or young children, or like Heather, a demanding job, two kids who need help from her at home, two dogs who are challenging, et cetera. What are some small ways, and I'd love to ask all of our panelists this, what are some small ways that you do sneak away, so to speak? I mean, in my case, it's very hard to get away from a 4-month-old or a 2-year-old, particularly the 2-year-old, for any time at all. So what are your tips and suggestions on how you make this happen?
I have started just recently. I do a quick guided journal each morning, and it's like 5 minutes, and it helps. And then the other thing is, a couple years ago, I read a really great book called Drop the Ball, and it talks about how you really, and I'm not always good at following this. Let me say this. I'm the queen of reading all these books, and then I forget them. But Drop the Ball was
least
really
you
good.
read
It be
them.
Yes, I read them. But it did talk about how you need to engage with your with someone else to help you if you can. And this means if you need to get someone to come in and clean your house, which in COVID can be a little scary, so we may not want to do that. Or even she talked about how, because I would do this, like my husband will load the dishwasher and then I'll sit there and secretly redo it, right? Because I'm anal and I'm like, oh, that's not the way you load the dishwasher, right? Letting go of that to get back some time. But talking about the model, drop the ball is really good because if you're going to work, you need that ability to do it. And so I suggest that is a place to start for tips on how to kind of redo your life a little bit. Not that I'm following it very well. Don't ask right now.
I love it. I think these are all great. It all feeds into the same place, right? Like it's almost like taking time for yourself because you know how important you are to make sure that the rest of the chaos works, right? Anyone else, Brittany or Serena, Stevie, anyone want to like jump in and share what are your little moments or your tips on how you make time for yourself?
I'll
Serena?
admit I'm not very good at this. I'll
Nice.
Would you say Brittany?
admit I'm probably the worst example there is. I'm also a fairly new mom, so it's going to be a transition for me. I know that, and I think recognizing that helps. And yes, people saying intention is half the battle is very true. I just haven't perfected it yet.
I can share a couple of things that have been working for me like lately, and like one from new mom perspective that took me a while to get my head wrapped around, but now we have a process in place in our home that's super helpful. And that one I'll go with first is just I have an agreement with my husband that once a week, mama's getting out of the house. I'm going to have free time. They have boys' night. We have 1 4-year-old, and sometimes I run errands, which I'm going to say does not really count. So I have to remind him, like, I'm going to run errands. Doesn't exactly count. I might be needing 2 nights this week. But sometimes I'll just like go to the mall and like walk around, or I'll go sit in my car somewhere and read, or like just my go-to before pandemic was to go have like a glass of wine and like read my book somewhere where no one but the waiters asking me for anything other than like, do you want more wine? The best thing in the world. I know a lot of extroverts are like, you'll go to the restaurant by yourself. I'm like, hey, I love that. I am down for it. I can do it. I know it's not comfortable for everyone, so I totally understand that too. And then one thing I did recently that was so helpful, because I feel like I've been like in pandemic lockdown. I've been in hibernation mode with the winter, and I'm just like flooping over it. So I wrote out a list of like, what are my 2021 adventures? Like, what do I want to do? I want to go on hikes. I want to like go do things. And just like, if I do nothing on that list, it's okay, because my brain like just released all this like great potential of like, cool. Like, I just spent like 10 minutes Googling hikes, or like, you know, just looking at what's out there and knowing that it's there. And if I get to it, that's great. And if I don't, that's okay. but it's there. It's on my list. And we did one this past weekend, so I'm super excited. I wrote like a checkbox and the date and all these things. I feel like I have accomplished something. And then my last one is just, I use my calendar at work a lot, and I have a category on my calendar that is self-care time. And okay. I had so much guilt in the beginning that I would block out an hour from 12 to 1. If you ever try to like book anything on my calendar, it's blocked. And it was lunch / self-care. And I was like, ooh, I don't know if I should be taking that time. Like I could eat at my desk and I could get more done. And I was like, you need to do it. You need to do it. And because I've been doing it for so long, it's my habit. It's there. It's blocked out time. Like you really can't block over it. If there's like an emergency something or like the timing doesn't work, I will move that hour to earlier or later. But that hour every day in the middle of the day, I am such a more efficient worker. If I go eat, take a break, walk away from my computer and actually do the thing that my calendar says to do, I probably get like more work done than if I just like charge through it.